Let us sing to the Lord, for he has gloriously triumphed. The Lord is my strength and my might. He has become my salvation. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you. Today is Thursday, April 22nd, Thursday of the third week of Easter, and Mass this morning is offered for the repose of the soul of Veronica Byrd. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, let us feel your compassion more readily during these days when, by your gift, we have known it more fully, so that those you have freed from the darkness of error may cling more firmly to the teachings of your truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The angel of the Lord spoke to Philip, "Get up and head south on the road that goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza, the desert route." So he got up and set out. Now there was an Ethiopian eunuch, a court official of the Candace, that is, the queen of the Ethiopians, in charge of her entire treasury, who had come to Jerusalem to worship and was returning home. Seated in his chariot, he was reading the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit said to Philip, "Go and join up with that chariot." Philip ran up and heard him reading Isaiah the prophet and said, "Do you understand what you are reading?" He replied, "How can I unless someone instructs me?" So he invited Philip to get in and sit with him. This was the scripture passage he was reading. "Like a sheep he was led to the slaughter, and as a lamb before its shearer is silent, so he opened not his mouth. In his humiliation justice was denied him. Who will tell of his posterity? For his life is taken from the earth." Then the eunuch said to Philip in reply, "I beg you, about whom is the prophet saying this? About himself or about someone else?" Then Philip opened his mouth, and beginning with this scripture passage, he proclaimed Jesus to him. As they traveled along the road, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, "Look, there is water. What is to prevent my being baptized?" Then he ordered the chariot to stop, and Philip and the eunuch both went down into the water, and he baptized him. When they came out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord snatched Philip away, and the eunuch saw him no more, but continued on his way, rejoicing. Philip came to Azotus and went about proclaiming the good news to all the towns until he reached Caesarea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Bless our God, you peoples. Loudly sound his praise. He has given life to our souls and has not let our feet slip. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Hear now, all you who fear God, while I declare what he has done for me. When I appealed to him in words, praise was on the tip of my tongue. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Blessed be God who refused me not, my prayer or his kindness. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Your blessing, Father.
The Lord be in your heart and on your lips, and proclaim his gospel worthily and well. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
I am the living bread that came down from heaven, says the Lord. Whoever eats this bread will live forever.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to the
Lord. Jesus said to the crowds, "No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draw him, and I will raise him on the last day. It is written in the prophets, they shall all be taught by God. Everyone who listens to my Father and learns from him comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father, except the one who is from God. He has seen the Father. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the desert, but they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Just a couple of things at the beginning here, and one of them is another invitation to join us this weekend, Good Shepherd Weekend, during our 40 hours of Eucharistic adoration, in which we are invited to spend time with Jesus, the bread of life, who gave his flesh for us and who remains with us in the Eucharist. So if you haven't had an opportunity to look at that already, I encourage you to grab a bulletin on your way out and see if you might join us. Certainly for any of our events, but especially for some hours with our Eucharistic Lord. And the second is just a note of gratitude for one of the things that the Lord seems to be doing here. We had our first confessions last night, and afterward in the sacristy, the priests were remarking the Holy Spirit is really at work. They were remarking especially about how powerful the parent confessions were last night. And so each of the students had at least one parent who came to the sacrament, and the priest just reported that these were outstanding confessions. And so we praise God for what he's doing in the hearts of our people here at Good Shepherd. Now, when we encounter sacred scripture, I propose that there are a couple of different ways that we can look at it. One of those is to see that these are events that happened, things that took place. And so, for example, there was a man named Philip, a disciple of the Lord, who heard the voice of the Lord, and who not only heard the voice of the Lord, but heeded that voice. Now, there was a man named Philip who approached this Ethiopian, who was at worship and reading scripture, and they engaged in a conversation. And as a result of the conversation, this Ethiopian was baptized and became a member of the household of Christ. And this man, Philip, continued to proclaim the name of Jesus Christ throughout the land. This is something that happened. And it's illustrative of what was happening in the life of the early church as these apostles and disciples went out proclaiming the good news. And so certainly one of the ways that we can approach scripture is to maybe marvel at, be grateful for, and just consider that these are things that actually happened in the history of our church. And then another way that we can approach scripture is to say that the Lord is revealing in here something he desires to do in my life. And that the Lord is speaking to me here and now through these events that happened at another time. And so if we consider Scripture in this way, just two invitations, two considerations based on our first reading today from the Acts of the Apostles. And one of them would be to ask in prayer, Lord, how is it that you're calling me to be more like the Ethiopian? Where are the areas where I need answers? How is it that I can be more like this Ethiopian, seeking answers to my questions about the faith, my questions about Scripture, my questions about the Lord? So that I don't let those questions pass me by. Because often it's in the area where we're uncertain, or in the area where there might even be tension, that the Lord has so much to offer us, and where we can experience such great growth in the spiritual life. And so very important for us not to just let those questions go unanswered, but to seek answers where they might be found. And so, Lord, how can I be more like this Ethiopian, seeking answers to my questions? And then how can I be more like Philip? Like, Lord, how are you calling me to be more like Philip, leading others to Jesus Christ? And we see in the Scripture today a couple of ways that Philip goes about this work of sharing the good news. One is that he simply engages in conversation. Do you understand this? Let's talk about it. Right? And as a result of his sharing what he knew about Jesus Christ in the course of just a conversation, an intimate conversation, another person comes to embrace Jesus Christ. Like, Lord, where are the conversations that you would like me to have? Who are the people that you would like me to approach? And then we also see that Philip just goes out straight proclaiming the good news. And not necessarily looking for an individual conversation, but saying, Jesus Christ is Lord. And Lord, are there any areas where you're asking me to do that? Any times or places where you desire me to more boldly and clearly proclaim Jesus Christ? And so as we encounter this act today of one of the apostles, as we encounter this work of the early church, we might ask the Lord, Lord, what is it that you are speaking to me through this Scripture today? Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross. And by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith, we proclaim
and profess your resurrection until you come.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, and Andrew, his assistant, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you. May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Christ died for all, that those who live may live no longer for themselves, but for him who died for them and is risen. Alleluia.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Paul,
pray for us.
Praise be Jesus Christ.
Now.